Stasha's mother, Katrina, learned her baby had a single ventricle defect just 16 weeks into her pregnancy.
Care for our patient with single ventricle type of heart disease begins at the moment of diagnosis, and today that's as a fetus. And the care strategy starts exactly at that point in time, as early as 16 or 18 or 20 weeks gestation.
They start prepping you from the minute you walk in the door, your first appointment. They kind of lay it all out, the plan, but they keep you in the moment, which is really helpful. They don't let you get too far ahead of yourself. So you know what's coming, but emotionally you stay connected to the spot that you're in with your child, and that helps.
The development of ultrasound, and in particular fetal echocardiography, has revolutionized and changed the entire landscape of how we diagnose single ventricle type of congenital heart disease.
The imaging quality is just amazing, especially when you think about the fact that the heart is constantly beating and it's constantly moving. Some of these hearts that are as small as a hummingbird, it seems like, that people can capture not only the delicate anatomy of the heart, but also be able to give us valuable information about the physiology is something that's very helpful to us.
And they would go through it every week, and if there were any changes, they would talk about the changes that had happened and how they would deal with that. And as scary as it was, at least we were mentally ready for when it happened.
At the time of birth, when there still will be some stress, it will be a different degree than what it would have otherwise been. They'll be more prepared and more educated about what's going to be happening to the baby after birth.
For the parents of a child that is going to have that surgery, if they know about it before the child is born, again, the situation would be completely different.